Hey, welcome back to Mindful May. This is a long-awaited video from myself personally, my sewing room update. So if you've been around a while, you would have seen most of my DIY or sewing videos were done in the house that we rented and in my space in particular. It was kind of like this patio that they walled in on the side of the house. It was 8 by 8 feet, pretty small, and I grew out of that space pretty quickly, but I am very grateful for it, even though I have moved on to bigger and better things. It is where Mindful May started. So we bought this house at the end of 2023, and initially the space downstairs off of the front door was my husband's office space. You can see his guitars and his desk and his workspace, but we realized pretty quickly that he can't really close the door, so that wasn't really working for us. I was using this space actually for my sewing studio. We realized that I needed more storage, so we switched places, and now he's actually next door in the second bedroom. This will become the guest room at some point. We'll get there. And now I have that room that's off of the main entrance. So in refurnishing and organizing my space, I definitely needed storage as there is not a closet in that space. So I wanted to thrift or find things on Facebook Marketplace as much as possible. I love to find things secondhand. I was able to find a table, a bookshelf, and my chair all secondhand, which I was really happy about. Just got this table off of Marketplace for $35. It's got a few blemishes, but since my sewing machine is going to be on top of it, I thought they didn't really matter, and $35 was a pretty good price. I just drove an hour away to get this bookshelf that is in my trunk now. It's so beautiful. It's pure oak and it's for my fabric storage, but boy howdy, what a project to get it in the car. And now I have an hour drive home. I feel very dedicated to this project, but also kind of silly for going out to the middle of nowhere, like crazy windy roads, all for a Facebook Marketplace find, but I think it'll be worth it. I really wanted to find some kind of like dresser system, something with a lot of small drawers to organize my sewing supplies and kind of my notions and bias binding and things. I was running into the problem of not being able to fit it into my car or it being really ugly. I had my eye on the Alex drawers from IKEA. Those are kind of a classic sewing space storage solution. We had a planned trip to my in-laws and they live just outside of Portland. So we decided we'll just go to IKEA, pick up a few other things for the house and get the Alex drawers. So we made a whole day of it. And of course, had to get some veggie dogs on our way out and then load up the car for our 7-hour drive home. I did also get some wooden hangers at IKEA to replace these black plastic ones. Just this simple change brought me so much joy. And then assembled the Alex drawers. This was a very difficult job. Thankfully, my husband helped me. He did everything except for assembling the drawers. I then went thrifting with my sister on the lookout for a chair and found this amazing kind of like retro mid-century office chair. It was a set of two, but I didn't need to. I just got the one and it was $5. I was really excited. And then it came time to kind of organize the space. I am hopefully finishing up my studio soon. I got my drawers and it's time to organize them, put some stuff in them. And I would like to get rid of the pink filing cabinet. So moving everything from that into the Alex drawers. Got some of my other notions from upstairs and they need to go into the top of the drawers. got some bias binding and elastic and such, so need to organize a few more things. I have my hardware and zippers in the first drawer, bias binding and elastic, got backup needles, interfacing, some smaller hardware. I've got my cutting tools in here, backup thread, and lots of buttons. I have paper patterns by Simplicity and McCall's that I want to make soon. And then lots more fabric. And then my paper goods, just notebooks and a crossword. I love crosswords. And then my sewing machine oil tends to spill if it's not upright, so it stays in here. And then my art supplies. I've got watercolors, colored pencils, and whatnot. Something else that I really wanted for this space was a big mirror. I had a couple of Facebook Marketplace flops where I was looking at this mirror, going to go pick it up, and then last minute measured my car, and it was going to be too tight, like 2 inches too big. So I had to say, sorry, I can't pick it up. And then I had another pickup lined up for a weekend when my in-laws were here and I could borrow their truck. I told him I can pick it up on Saturday when my in-laws are here. And he said, cool, sounds good. Saturday rolls around. I check the listing and it's sold. So I was getting kind of impatient because I had been working on this project and this was like the last piece that I needed. So I decided to just buy the mirror new with some money that I recently made from a dress that I sold. So Amazon to the rescue. It came in the mail 1 week later and it's so beautiful. I was praying that it wasn't shattered, but it turned out to be packaged really well and it looks beautiful in my space. Now for the final reveal. This is not like a crazy before and after. I didn't buy my own sewing shed or spend $1,000, but it has everything that I need in the space, and I think it's really beautiful. My space. I'm really grateful for the upgrade. It cost me about $340 altogether, and I'm so excited to film more sewing videos in there. I know it's been a while since I've made one, but now that I have my space set up, I've got lots more ideas and videos to come soon. So thanks so much for supporting Mindful May. I'll see you in the next one. Cheers!